Hello, today I'd like to show you our custom web action. These custom web actions within ABBYY FlexiCapture give us the ability to expand what we can do from a web verification perspective. Now, what you see in front of us is a document, and what I want you to see here is that I have a couple of fields, and then I have a button with an ellipsis beside it. This ellipsis is what we refer to as a custom web action. This gives us the ability to kind of do other things. We can open up other windows. We can ask for other information. We can kind of do things to do our own custom work on the web side of things. So that way we aren't limited kind of by rule enforcement and those things that we have here at the web verification station out of the box. So for example, I have an action where if I type in something here and I select this button and I enter a value, the software will then append that value and put the full appended value here in the other field. Now, it's obviously a very basic example of what happens, but let me kind of explain a little bit deeper what's going on. This button is giving us the ability to inject some information on the screen, potentially a custom-based form. This is all custom. I'll show you this behind the scenes here in 1 minute. But now we can control this interface. We can control the color, the background, the logo. We can control what's on the screen. We can control the user interaction of the screen. We can do all sorts of fun things. We can prompt users. We can call other outside systems. We can refer to document data sets here. All of this by expanding what we're doing with this custom web action. So our options are limitless here. We have a lot of options on how we want to use this window to kind of customize the user experience of ABBYY FlexiCapture from a web perspective. So even though my demo for you today is very basic, the idea of what you can do here and what we've done with clients is very vast. So let me show you a little bit behind the scenes of how this works. What I'll do is I'll open our document definition. When I open that, you can see here I have the same two fields that I showed you on the demo there. If I go into the sample one field and I go into our custom action tab, down below you'll see there's an option for enabling web custom actions, and you can provide a script. Here is an example of the script that we did. ABBYY actually has terrific documentation on how this is meant to happen. But out of the box, you can kind of see that we have the ability to control the styling of the form. We can control the HTML markup of the form. We can refer to things on the document in other fields. And we can even refer to things like I referred to as data sets. And we can control the data set and filtering and all of those cool things. But you can see here, without going line by line through the code, what happens here, right? We can obviously declare some HTML markup and CSS. We can apply those here. We can put our own function into this process. So my markup contained a cancel button, and now I'm mapping a JavaScript function to the cancel button, and the same for the gather results function. And here you can see here's my gather results function that happens here. This is frankly being just as simple as saving the field. So I put in the hyphen here in between the two fields that I showed you in the demo. This is a very basic example of a custom web action. But obviously, your mind can be as creative with this as you want. Now you can give the ability for the user to add other things that sometimes maybe out of the box interfacing is hard to do or isn't obvious to the end user or is a little bit tricky to run some business rules around. Now we have the ability to kind of customize that experience and make it really a user-friendly experience versus kind of a clunky walkthrough from a user validation perspective. So, once you're done here and you've provided your information and your custom scripts and your function, you have the ability, of course, to publish your document definition. Once you're published with your document definition, now on the website, you'll see this ellipsis because you have that enabled with a script. And now you can enjoy exploring different ways to customize this entry form or make it yours and enjoy the ability to take the user experience and make it much more vast. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any other questions, please feel free to reach out to us.
Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, would you do me a favor and click the like button, the subscribe button, and even click that notification bell so that you can be notified when we post new videos. Thank you.